I'm going to read for you a story called Snow White. One snowy day, a queen sat sewing by her window. She accidentally pricked her finger with a needle, and 3 drops of blood fell on the snow. The queen looked at bright red blood on the white snow against the black wood of the window frame and thought, "I wish I had a child with the lips as red as blood, skin as white as snow, and hair as black as ebony wood." Sometime after that, the queen gave birth to a little girl with deep red lips, snowy white skin, and glossy hair as black as ebony. She called her Snow White. Sadly, the queen died and the king married again. His new wife was beautiful but cruel and selfish. She had a magic mirror, and every day she looked into it and asked, "Mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the fairest one of all?" And every day the mirror replied, "You, O queen, are the fairest of them all." But as Snow White grew up, she grew more beautiful. And so one morning, the queen's mirror said to her, "You, O queen, are fairer, it's true. But Snow White is much fairer than you." In a jealous rage, the queen called her huntsmen. "Take Snow White into the forest and kill her," said her. The huntsman took Snow White to the edge of the forest, but he could not bear to hurt her. "Run away, child," he said. Poor frightened Snow White, she was all alone, lost in the forest, running for her life. Towards nightfall, Snow White came to a little cottage deep in the woods. She knocked softly, but there was no answer. So she let her inside. Inside, Snow White found a table and 7 tiny chairs. Upstairs, there were 7 little beds. "I'm so tired," she yawned. And she lay down and fell asleep. A while later, she woke up with a start. 7 little men were standing around her. "Who are you?" she asked. "We are the 7 dwarfs who live here," said one of the little men. "We work in mines all day. Who are you?" "I am Snow White," she replied, and she told them her sad story. The dwarfs felt sorry for Snow White. "If you cook and clean for us," said the eldest dwarf, "you can stay here and we will keep you safe." Snow White gratefully agreed. When they left for work the next day morning, the dwarf made Snow White promise not to go out or open the door or speak to anyone. Meanwhile, the queen was back at her magic mirror, but she was shocked by what it told her. "You are the fairest here, it's true, but there is someone fairer than you deep in the forest in a cozy den. Snow White lives with 7 little men. "What?" shrieked the woman queen. "Snow White is alive. The queen, who was really a wicked witch, brewed a deadly poison and poisoned a rosy red apple. Then, disguising herself as old woman, she set out for the 7 dwarfs' cottage. Snow White was busy in the kitchen when she saw an old woman at the window. "Try my lovely red apples," the woman croaked. And she handed the poisoned apple to Snow White. She took a big bite and fell down dead. The queen hurried home to her magic mirror. At last, it gave her the answer she wanted. You, O Queen, are the fairest of all of them. The dwarfs wept bitterly when they found Snow White dead. They didn't want to bury her, and so they put her in a glass coffin. They watched over her day and night. One day, a prince came riding through the forest. When he saw Snow White, he instantly fell in love with her. "Please let me take the coffin back to my castle," he begged the dwarfs, and they agreed. As the prince's servant lifted the coffin, one of them stumbled and a piece of apple that was stuck in Snow White's throat came loose. Snow White opened her eyes. Snow White looked into the prince's kind, gentle eye, and she knew she loved him too. And so they were married with the dwarf beside them. They all lived happily together in Prince Castle for the rest of the long life. So that's it.